So, whilst Michael's been working on a customer's trailer this morning, replacing calipers, I've been doing some sanding. That's something to just keep in mind. If you haven't checked your trailer out lately, go ahead and check it out. Make sure that everything's good and functioning on it, okay? People forget their trailers and then can't understand where they get stuck at the side of the road. So just getting a little bit off track, but just take a minute, check your trailer out if you have a book. So I've been working on this morning. You probably have seen some before pictures. I hope we have before pictures, but anyway. What we did was we came in and glassed the spots that had holes in them. And what we did was we originally plugged them and then we feathered it back and then we put 1708 and glass. I can't remember the combination. And I've been working on bringing this down this morning to get it flat. One of the things I've noticed is this is not particularly level. It's kind of wavy as you would expect on a boat this age. I mean, nothing bad, but something to kind of keep in mind when you're working on it. So I've been taking it down. I've been using this stuff here, and this stuff is for showing high and low spots, because obviously I want to get the high spots, but I don't want to be sanding a bunch where there is low spots. And it works pretty well. We're going to have to do a little work up here. I don't want to put too much filler or anything up here, but we're going to have to probably put a skim coat on this to get it reasonably level. But it does have, you know, you have your trolling motor here, right, which has been bolted up. So you've got kind of like a...
On the other side.
Sorry.
Well, you know, some people get really... really irritated about trolling motors.
You could have, you know, there is not a law that says you can't have your trolling motor this way. There's not a law that says you can't have your trolling motor this way. You can have your trolling motor whichever way you want.
All right, calm down, take it easy.
The trolling motor is this way, for those people that don't know, like me. But anyway, so you have, that kind of explains a lot, actually. So you have where the trolling motor was, kind of like in one plane. Then we had something in here. I can't remember. What did we have here?
Nav light.
Nav light here. And then we had some other stuff over here. And it kind of explains it now on why I've got like two or three different directions. So just kind of keep that in mind if you're working on it. Fortunately, as we're going to be putting another trolling motor on, it's not going to be really that big a deal. But I want it to be reasonably perfect, okay? You know, we're not making a... you know, a concourse car or a concourse boat here. This is going to be a used boat, not a used boat, but we're actually going to use this boat. So we want it to be functional, but we want it to be good looking, and we want to continue to try to hone our skills. And I'm honing my sanding skills, and I really don't like it, but that's just part of life. I've been working on this. We did put some skim coats on this side. I'm going to be going down the side. This here is fairly flat right now. And these are excellent. I'm colorblind, but that looks red to me.
It is.
Was this red at one point in time?
No, because they spray it in layers.
Okay. So anyway, so we've been filling the holes. Probably should have been a little bit better on this. I used too aggressive sandpaper. So the next time we do something like this, don't do like I did. Use a less aggressive, but you want to kind of scratch it up so the filler sticks, but not like that. Don't do what I did. So we've been working on this. Back here, as you know, we had these holes and we got this here. This is fairly flat. Oh, what's going on there? So that's what I've been working on, really, just basically sanding. I didn't set up the camera this morning because Michael was over there working on the brake calipers and stuff, but I want to try to get a bunch of this sanding out of the way today. That's really what it's all about. This here is set up beautifully. I mean, this is like a rock. You know, what's that guy that sings that song? I can't remember, but anyway. Don't be breaking it off. So this is really, really sturdy. It's amazing. not really, because we knew it was going to be that way. So we're going to be cleaning this up a little bit, and then we're going to start to lay glass, but we need to put the other side in first. And I want to be really careful when we glass this in that we don't put too much down. One of the problems I had up here, quite honestly, we had a lot of glass here. So we want to work on that. It's kind of one of those fine lines, just so that you know, between not having enough and having too much. Over here, we didn't have enough. Over here, we had too much. So we'll get better at that as time goes on, or we'll try. Maybe by the end of the project, we'll get it figured out. I've not sanded down those two pieces. I need to sand those down. You know, we're getting pretty far along on this now, as far as, you know, all the bodywork and stuff goes. Once we get that in place, then it's just going to be more of the same of glass, 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 sand, 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 glass, sand, sand, glass, whatever. But that's kind of it, really. It was nice to get a break, go help Michael bleed the brakes. So that's it, really. So that's your update for today. Make sure if you do this, you wear your protective stuff. I've got to say, this cotton shirt did help tremendously.
So fresh it hurts.
You know, get where in the past I've itched and what have you, so it does work really well. So if you're kind of allergic to that, just kind of keep that in mind. So anyway, you all have a good day. So Michael has been reassembling the locker boxes this morning. As from previous videos, however they come out, you already know that we put this one back in place over here. These two pieces we had already glassed on two sides. One of the things, I guess, advice that I would give, if you're going to do this, we've had to take them in and out several times. And I can't remember the reasons. Well, some of the reasons, obviously, is to grind everything back. And other reasons, I don't remember every reason why it had to come in and out as many times as it did. But it seemed like every time we put it back, it was never quite the same. So my advice would be, is if you're going to do this, get on it and get it done and get it in place. I think you'll end up saving yourself a tremendous amount of time from having to refit stuff. Now, obviously, this piece here and that piece there was going to have to refit no matter what, because we put glass on either side to save ourselves time and effort of glassing it whilst it was in place. So the other thing is, it makes it easy to remember how it all goes back together. We did notice, one of the things we did notice, or Michael noticed this morning, is we have to make an adjustment in here for everything to be symmetrical. When we did this, this piece here needs to be lined up with this edge over here, so that it's the same width all the way down. This top is in there because we was having trouble revisualizing everything, and that, quite honestly, plays a big part in this, is, you know, visualizing how this all goes together. Some of it we've already gone in, Michael's already gone in and used the thickened epoxy and put a radius in the corners and stuff, which we're going to need for where we glass it in, and we're going to be doing more of that today, and kind of getting it ready to put a thin layer of glass on the top just to hold everything in place. And then after that, we're going to go in and put our trim piece around the inside so that we can have a lip to try to make the lockers as water resistant as possible. So that's the general idea right now. I think it was a little bit of a brain tease for Michael this morning. The other thing is, obviously, is probably do it better than we have done is mark everything and put it somewhere safe so you don't break it by standing on it. I've said before, we're running a business, so sometimes Michael's running a business, so sometimes what ends up happening is you get off doing installs, working on trailers and that, and then you come back to this and you have to restart over and find all the pieces and stuff. So probably need to be a little bit more diligent ourselves on our projects so we're not creating more work. The other thing that we did do yesterday is we cleaned the boat. We did a tremendous amount of sanding yesterday, so Michael washed the boat off. I strongly advise you keeping up with that during the process, because the amount of dust and glass that you keep down whilst you're working on it makes it more and more bearable. The other thing, obviously, is not use it as a toolbox. You know, you tend to end up using it as a toolbox. All the tools end up in here. So that's, I guess, some other advice that I would give is try to keep the boat as the boat and not as your toolbox or where you're storing everything. Obviously, we're working on it today, so the stuff is back out. But yesterday, we had a tremendous amount of tools laying in the boat, and that's probably not the right thing. So that's kind of where we're at, and we're getting down to the nitty-gritty now of glassing this stuff where it's in place. We've got to make sure we have radiuses where we need radiuses and straights where we need straights and all that kind of stuff. So we're kind of doing this today, and we're talking it through, and we'll probably make some notes to make sure we get the radiuses in where we need the radiuses, and then the right angles where we need the right angles and stuff like that. Piece of wood where we need a piece of wood for the hinges and stuff like that. So that's kind of what we're working on right now. So that's kind of the update we have. And I'll keep you tuned in as the day goes on. Thank you. So we've been working on doing the reinstall. What we did do, we've gone around and laid a thin layer of glass on the top of the pink foam. And one of the reasons why we did that is because we had joints and stuff. This stuff really is not, you know, structural. We're obviously going to have to score it up for when we start putting the 1708 down, but we wanted to try to get everything firmed up. The 1708 is fairly thick, and it takes a lot to get the epoxy in it. So what we wanted to do was have a, you know, this thing is almost translucent. So we have a very thin layer of glass down, we've epoxied over the top of it, we'll come rough that up, and then we'll start to lay the glass and stuff down on top of it. We've been going through with the epoxy filler, filling in spaces and stuff. We did put a thin layer of glass down at the bottom, so it held it in place and stopped it from kicking backwards and forwards. Really kind of happy with the way that turned out. I'm super excited when you look at it from this end. I don't know why, it's just one of those things that caught my eye this morning. If you look at it down this way, we need to move that crossbar, we don't really need it anymore. But if you look at it down this way, that's going to be really something when it's done. And it just kind of caught my eye, and I thought, wow, I really like the way that looks. We obviously got a long way to go. But, you know, slowly but surely, we have done a tremendous amount of work on this the last couple of days. and also delivered a couple of boats at the same time. So we've been really kind of hitting it hard. Michael has been hitting it real hard. The other thing that we've been working on a little bit this morning that I would like to suggest to you, if you're going to do this, and it's something that we really needed to work on, is we're prepping all of our glass for what we're going to be laying down. So the stuff that you don't see on camera and the stuff that nobody ever really gets to see is the discussion about how we're going to be laying up the glass, how we're going to be doing 1708 chop strand, 1708 chop strand, the radiuses and stuff, all those kind of things. So we're not going to spend hours showing you us cut, you know, 2-inch wide strips of 1708. That's going to be going on obviously behind the scenes, but we want to have all this glass cut in advance so that when we start to lay up, you know, we're ahead of the game. Michael and I are probably both not very good at this. We get, you know, let's get gung-ho and we get ahead of the curve. So we're going to be doing this, we're going to be coming in and cutting all this stuff up, and we're going to be, that's probably not the best way to do it, but we're going to be rolling this stuff up and having it marked up for where it goes in the boat. That way we're not running into epoxy problems, timing problems, things like that. This 1708 is really difficult to cut straight. It moves on you. I haven't got very good at this yet, but I figure by the time I get through cutting all this up, I'll have a system down, which I'll be willing to share with you. We're also going to bring out the cutting table, but we're going to have everything laid out. So this is the kind of the stuff that goes on behind the scenes. If you use this 1708 stuff, I would treat it very gently. We've not probably been, we've kind of abused this sheet, and I think it's kind of shown because it gets twisted and stuff. So if you get a sheet in, I would strongly urge you to take good care of it and lay it out. The other thing is, if you can get it in a roll, it's better. This came all folded up, and I don't think it's the best way for it. So obviously the cheapest way to ship it, but not necessarily the best way for you when you're laying, trying to lay out or cut certain sections. Get yourself a good pair of shears and don't let Michael use them when he's doing epoxying. The one thing that, about the epoxy side of it is to be careful with your tools and stuff when you're epoxying or whatever, you, because it gets all over your tools and you can ruin some pretty expensive tools real fast. So, you know, maybe your second or third line tools that you've had for a while, if you've been around like I have, you have some stuff that you've kind of graduated from, but that's really good for when you're doing this epoxy work, because quite honestly, you know, some of the newer stuff that we have, we sure as hell don't want to tear it up. So been a good couple of days, and we're going to continue on with this. One other thing I want to bring up, this is basically done. I've obviously used the stuff to show that I'm level. So this area is basically done now. I'm very happy with the way it turned out. I got to do the finish sand, the lighter grades of paper and stuff, but I think we should do that as we start to bring all this stuff down. We start to use the lighter papers and stuff at that particular time, but maybe Michael can add in some photographs of what this looked like before and what it looks like now. I can rub my hand over it, but it's fairly flat. But as I said yesterday, you can definitely tell where the trolling motor was because there's a definite line, and there's no way around it. So Michael went and did the repair job here. We're waiting for this to set up. And that was 1708 chop strand, 1708 chop strand. We had to kind of build that up. We don't really know what... Something happened here, and the previous owner tried to do a repair, and I think they just stuck some stuff on and didn't prep it. And it's if you do this, you've got to prep the area that you're going to epoxy to. If you don't, it'll come off. So we've done really well at the filled holes. I've still got this hole to finish up right here. But if you look at some of the holes on the back, we are just... Check this one out here. That was a like a 1-inch diameter hole right there, no longer there. We got these over here, another 1-inch. like an inch and a half hole here. And let me tell you, just as you can see, all the other holes working well. I haven't come back and sanded this off yet. I will. We had some little kind of like indentations, so we're taking those out so I can get it all down at one level. It just takes time and patience. We've been talking about the development of this. We're pretty sure now we're going to go with carpet in here. And Michael's kind of come up with some color combinations and stuff, and I think it'll turn out real nice. Quite honestly, I think it, you know, it's kind of at that point where we're kind of getting into that stage of developing the next stage of the boat. So what we've been working on, we've been talking about these things today, because we have to obviously start to prep to bring the materials in for that stage, if not the build stops. So I think we're still up in the air on the lids. I got a feeling that Michael is going to go with metal lids. We actually talked about a combination of metal, doing one metal, one composite and stuff like that. I do believe composites are the future of boats. I personally do. I think as time goes on, composites are going to play a bigger part in boats than you've ever seen before. It's becoming more efficient, more economical way to do it. We obviously do not have that process totally down, but I think our skills have increased as we've gone on with this particular stuff. And that's what it's all about, is developing your skills, learning each and every day. And, you know, I'm fortunate to work with Michael and learn, and he knows a lot of stuff about this that I don't know, about the different combinations of materials and stuff. I get fed up with listening to all that stuff. So very happy with the way this turned out. We've messed it up again, so I'm gonna have to go back and fix it. This is an area that we're really bad at, is when we epoxy, we manage to get epoxy everywhere. And quite honestly, we've got to work on getting better at that, because it creates work that we have to come back and sand off, especially when I've spent all this time finishing this section through here, and then we get a big old blobs of epoxy on it and I have to come back and redo it. So it's obviously something that we have to work on, and we don't try to hide anything from everybody. We're just like you guys. You know, we make mistakes, and I could sit here and say, oh, you know, that's not the way it is. You know, we get frustrated with each other some days, and Michael gets fed up with listening to me most days. But if you look at where this boat has come from, especially over the past few weeks, we are moving along. And I hope that in the next few days, we get that to a point. We're kind of, should we do this before this? And that's the indecision side. So we're going to have to make a decision and go one way, even if it's the wrong way. Because you can sit around and second guess yourself on that. And we're doing a little bit of that right now. Should we do this first or that first? So the bottom line is, we're just doing stuff, and it may not be right, and we'll share it with you. You know, some of you guys may have already made those mistakes. And so one last thing. Appreciate everybody's every single comment, but please remember to be respectful. We do not need F-bombs and other things in the comments. There is no need to go there, guys. The vast majority, 99.9% of people don't go there, but there's always the odd one or two, and we try to be a family channel. I don't always say the right things, but there is no place for calling people stupid and dropping F-bombs and this, that, the other. There's no place for that. We all learn. You know, so just kind of keep that in mind. I know the majority of you do, but if you're in the market for just putting that stuff out there, go watch something else. I mean, I'm sorry, I don't have the time and patience for you. So hate to be that way, but the majority of our viewers are not. But if you are the kind of guy that just likes to call people stupid and drop a bunch of F-bombs, I don't understand why you go down that road. So Michael will probably edit that out. But anyway, have a great day.